back to Super Essex Conference Colonial Division Basketball on the NFHS Network. Last place Livingston is looking to upset first place Caldwell once again on the NFHS Network.
He's going to take it himself for a championship! Oh. Atala Blair wins it the three!
Turn it to the end zone. What a catch! The Kayaton touchdown!
At guard, number 10, Chris Talavera. And center, number 23, Ian Madison. At guard, number 2, Ray Zaluk. At guard, number 5, Rocco Chico. And at forward, number 20, Ryan Lawrence. And the rest of the Caldwell team.
Colors.
Nation's colors and our starting lines are presented to you here at the NFHS Network. Lancer's looking at a different lineup versus this typical Caldwell starting lineup that we've seen all year. Lancer's going to be missing a key piece to start this one off.
Yeah, Avi Pellet will be in the starting five of Lancer's tonight. Despite the fact that he leads the team in rebounds, is second in free throws and two-pointers, and he has two steals to his name on the season, junior Luke Cohen. It's an interesting decision, but we'll see how the Lancers are able to do without him. Additionally, we have another call-up that we remain on the JV squad. He will be wearing number 24 for the Lancers. Ryan?
Moments away from tip-off as Massimo DiPaola his first ever varsity start. He wears number 50. We'll take the tip off for the Lancers, and let's play basketball here. It's a first versus last matchup in the third division in Essex County Hoops, as there's a three to get James Caldwell. Now the first point of the game coming from Ray Zamloot. And it's 3-0, James Caldwell High School. 10-minute trip they made here. Past Morris County on the ride. Livingston controls. Swung on out. Here's Luke Cohen, Sun coach in his 18th season at the helm of the program. Dave Cohen, as that one kicks right off his hands and out of bounds, James Caldwell will take over. We'll throw it in. Avi Pillay checks in immediately, so it's likely we saw a different starting lineup due to Massimo DiPaolo taking the tip. Got 40 seconds in. 3-0, James Caldwell. Zamloot swings it on out. Here's a fake three-point opportunity from Chiquetto. Swung on out. Zamloot gives it a long three ball coming here. That rims right on through to Talavera. Caldwell doubles their lead in the opening minutes of action. As Paulette gets his first offensive touches, Alex.
It's interesting to see. You talked to Coach Fess before the game about pushing the tempo. So far, Caldwell has done just that with another touch.
Chiquetto wants to get on the board. Throws one up. He is rejected. And Livingston likes to see that. They're trying to get on the board. It's Caldwell basketball. And Talavera, the five-time guard, will throw it in now for the Chiefs. Right back in we go here. Here's a contested three ball. That squeezes right through. You do not want to leave Talavera open. It's 9-0.
Talavera played so much before the game. Now you're seeing why. 2 3-pointers in the opening minute and a half of the ball game.
Avi Pallet. He's lightly contested by Chiquetto. They'll try and swing it around. Pallet over to big wrist. Wrist with a fierce face on the basketball will give it away. Luke Cohen from the point. Swung on over, Avi Pallet. Swings on through. It's on back to the point. Cohen gets too dancing with it. It's taken away. Zamloot with 3 points on the day as he misses the fast break. But Cohen cannot hold that ball.
Cheap ball.
So the Chiefs get the benefit of the doubt with around 6 minutes into this one.
Like I said, Coach Fest talked about. That is the third Lancers turnover in the first 2 minutes of this game. So far, Fest's game plan has worked.
Well, Caldwell, lightly contested at the three line, can finish. Side, hooked on up and no good. Rebound, Massimo DiPaolo, the JV call-up, making his presence known early. Squeezes one, pass too light, punched away.
And that's a fourth turnover.
So Matt Cain checks in. Last broadcast, he made a key start in Luke Cohen's absence due to illness. He will now check in. This junior class really dominating the roster for the Lancers this year in their four wins. Those 4 wins, the first round of the county tournament, upset versus Newark Collegiate Academy. A lot of Newark teams making themselves known here in Essex County Hoops. Avi Pallet gives it away. Big wrist is rejected. Basketball on the floor. Picked on up by James Caldwell. Taken away. Thrown on up. Rejected. James Caldwell. Picked on up. A 2-on-1. Thrown over K. And finished by Zamloot.
You gotta give him, you gotta give credit to Internet. He got that, he gave that dish. He uses his size as another turnover.
Lancers turning the ball over a lot. Another fish.
Coach Carter calls a timeout here. But like I mentioned, Madison is an athlete. He's tall, strong. We saw his height, his size, his athleticism led directly to that fast break opportunity.
It's Lancer basketball.
They need to get on the board here, Ryan. This game's going to end very, very quickly if you don't think it has.
Run on in, here's Avi Pallet. Pallet.
She's into it.
Matthew Kay. Kay. Bounce pass, Pallet. Can't finish. Rebound, up in the air, and taken away by Kala. Deflected off of DiPaolo. That's smart basketball.
It is. I just want to point out there, the Chiefs are making. That's another thing that Coach Fest talked about. Like I said, pushing the pace. Speaking of coaches, though, Coach Cohen talked about holding the Chiefs to minimal transition, which is something that they have not been able to do thus far as they trail by 13 halfway through this first quarter.
Basketball stabbed away and taken by the Lancers. K gives it to Pallet. Now back at the point. Avi Pallet with a bounce pass. Pearlstein, it's Jiggly with it, loses his dribble. checks around. Pallette finds a lane and can't fish, but will go line. Lancers trying to get themselves started here as we're over halfway into this first quarter.
Avi Pellet will be on the line, shooting two, fouls number 10, Chris Thomas's first.
I mentioned before, Pallette, 17 made free throws in 13 games played, is second to only Cohen on the line this year.
So the Lancers get themselves on the board here in the quarter. Avi Pallette, one for one, and now set up for his second as the gym falls silent. One for two, he will go. He gets defensive. We'll keep an eye on the big man. Ian Madison doing an excellent job off rebound so far. Mid-range jumper. Rim and out, rebound offensive. Madison pivots, can't finish. Paula, his pass, tipped out of balance. Lancer basketball. A good call there. Livingston, now trailing by 12, as Matt Kay will throw it in for them.
Slow start for the Lancers here. They haven't been, usually they're pretty good coming out of the first quarter, but out of the gate thus far, they haven't been able to put the ball in the basket, as we see another miss there.
DePaula, 0 for 2. Wild second shot backwards. First shot thrown a little too high. Driving on in, trying to finish, and now going to the line. Actually looks like turning it over right there. It is Ryan Lawrence. He charged.
That's a good take right there.
In the game for Caldwell, Lawrence.
Lawrence tried to power through. Just a little too powerful on that one. Livingston get the basketball back.
Did a good job of selling it, too.
Pearlstein squeezes by. Matt Kay. Good hops there from Pallette to keep the basketball in play. Pearlstein. Pearlstein having a great year for the Lancers in the junior season. Another year of eligibility as he pickpocketed but keeps the basketball as it rolls out of bounds into the abyss.
In the game for the Chiefs, Matt Cassell.
Mike Cassell enters the game for the Caldwell Chiefs. Okay. Whistles blow immediately, not a second shaved off the clock, as it looks like down four is senior Sam Bodner.
Curious to see what the call is here. We are going to have Lancers Wall underneath the hoop. They need to get some going here.
So Matt Kay will throw in the basketball for the Lancers. Matt Kay increasing his minutes each game for the Lancers, becoming a key piece. Bounce pass to DePaula. Defensive foul. Livingston will throw it in from the out-of-bounds marker under the net once again. And, well, the throw-in man, Matthew Kay, do his job once again.
Right now, I want to see a quick bucket from the Lancers. We have a quick cut, a catch and shoot. The Lancers need to get some momentum here because right now they have 1 point in 5 minutes of basketball played. They need to get something going.
Well, James Caldwell, as there's a pass on inside, and a finish from Pallette, as you say. And James Caldwell, their snipers behind the three line. They have a couple big guys specifically for them. Probably their biggest guy on the roster, Ian Madison, who stands at 6'5". A couple big guys, but they're really shooters from the three line. Livingston, lightly contesting them at the three line, I think has learned their lesson.
They have. Now you see Talladega getting covered much more closely from beyond the arc. The miscue from the Chiefs, it'll be Lancers Wall coming out from the base.
The 5'10 senior guard with the Matt Cassell overruns it as Sam Smith checks back in. Sam Smith, a senior. Smith, known as another Lancer sharpshooter. A lot of shots from behind the three line he takes per game. Here's Pearlstein as he gives it away to senior Sam Bodner. Sam Smith. Smith. Recourse. Recourse as he gives it away. Pearlstein. Three ball, Sam Smith. Can't get it to go, rim backboard and out. Rebound, Zanlut. Zanlut will take it up himself and shoot a three. Rim it out, Sam Smith gets the rebound. And Avi Pallette will take it up for the Lancers with under 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter of action on the D1 Media Pro page on the NFHS Network, Alex.
Looks like Cohen's going to check back into the game. Meanwhile, Coach Fest mentioned a slow pace from these Lancers on offense. As we see a foul, but Avi Pallette took his time coming up the court here, and that is exactly what Coach Fest was talking about. Meanwhile, on the other side of the court, Caldwell is playing catch and shoot, quick cuts, quick shots. It's been a completely polar opposite offensive affair for these two teams.
Got a minute and a half now left to go in the first quarter. Bounce pass. Remember, Lancers want to really tightly contest those three balls that come from James Caldwell that they didn't do right there. Won't cost him, though. However, on the offensive rebound is James Caldwell, but an excellent effort right there from Sam Bodner, and the Lancers are on the basketball with about 90 seconds left to go. Pass on outside, Cohen drives on in. Keeps himself in bounds as he gives it away. Inside, Sam Bodner bounce pass. Avi Pelez loses the basketball in the air as he's contested by three. We have whistles that come in.
Foul to number 11, Avi Pelez.
And Avi Pelez is called on the foul.
His first, team's first.
First foul of the day called against the Lancers, as pointed out by the real
Chiefs ball.
DJ Barry, Livingston Lancers basketball and baseball, PA announcer. See him over the spring, covering Lancers baseball, under coach Michael Ennis, who is also the freshman coach for this Lancers basketball program, who are in the JV quarterfinals this Saturday, as well as the freshman quarterfinals. James Caldwell still controls. Passed on out, faking a three ball, driving on in. Chiquetto outside. Big three ball once again from Zamloop. Pass taken away. Avi Pelez gets dancing with it. He drives on through and passes it on away. Cohen. Smith. Found inside is Pelez. Can't finish. Back on outside. 25 seconds of basketball left to be played. Three-pointer chucked it up. And finish. Pearlstein can shoot. And he showed it right there with 20 seconds left to play in the opening quarter of action on the D1 Media Pro page on the NFHS Network.
I'm no betting man, Ryan. But something's telling me that we're going to see a three ball shot up here by the Chiefs to close out this first quarter.
Sale gives it away. 2 seconds as Cohen is the guilty verdict.
And even on the shot after the whistle, jumping, midair shot, still glassing in. 2.2 seconds. More than enough time for a quick catch and shoot. Maybe Zamloot, maybe it's Talavera. But we're going to see a three ball here.
Passed on in. Pivot, chuck up, triple teamed, and unable to finish is Lorenzo Sozio, the 6 foot junior guard. So that'll do a first quarter that was dominated by Caldwell in the beginning. Lancers posted a little comeback. They switched the difference to just 7. We'll be right back for the second quarter next on the D1 Media Pro page on the NFHS Network.
Hey, but understand. Oh! Rojas took him and defeated
him. Ethan Horton. Horton dribbles into the front court to Khalil Whitney. Going to the basket and the jam.
Conversation with them because they are getting resources from the city. They are getting resources and they're arguing with us about the timeliness of those resources.
From the Fieldhouse Gymnasium in Livingston, Essex, New Jersey, it's Thursday night Super Essex Conference Hoops. James Caldwell trying to earn a promotion into the Liberty Division, the second division of all sports in the SEC Conference, and Livingston trying to spot themselves on up and try and pass the West Orange Mountaineers, a team that they will take on a week from tonight. That game will be at the Tarnoff Gymnasium and will be available on the on-demand function after its live stream on the D1 Media Pro page on the NFHS Network. Pearlstein, mid-range jumper from the three line, from the free throw line, is out as the rebound right there will come from Madison. Here comes James Caldwell. Chiquetto gives it away. Talavera on the outside, swings it over. Sozio back out for a three. No good. Bodner rebound as he's chased for it. He keeps it. One bounce and a pass away. And Pearlstein relays it on over. Avi Pelez. Pearlstein back on out. Bodner. Bodner just gives it away before it traveled. Pearlstein out to Cohen. Cohen leaves round. Throws one on up. He can't finish. Bricked on the shot.
Who else put Madison at the board, Ryan?
Three ball. No good. Pelez lightly contested on the rebound as he bounce passes it over to Bodner. Pearlstein plants for a three, and he does it.
That's three-pointer for Dylan Pearlstein.
And James Caldwell will call their first timeout. Both teams have burned one. But Livingston, right off the bat, they're cracking with it. They know they got to capitalize early in the second, as is exactly what James Caldwell did in the first, Alex.
That was Prosit's second three of the game, and he looks like he's getting really hot. I want to see him keep shooting. I want to see the Lancers feeding him, keep shooting the deep ball. And now they went from down 12, now it's a four-point spread, Ryan. It's a very, very attainable margin. I think we're going to see Nate Nussbaum check into the game. I'm not sure, but I think I'm getting going on the bench. So we'll see what this Lancers lineup is going to look like coming out of the timeout here, beginning in the second quarter. Lynch basketball.
And Ian, quickly making a reference to your keys to the game, if we take a quick look at them once again. You said Caldwell needs to bounce back. They bounced back immediately in the first quarter from their most recent loss as they were shooting on fire from the start and moved the ball. We've really seen Livingston move the ball actually a ton, but Caldwell also doing a little bit of movement to plant themselves behind the three line. So an excellent job on your keys to the game.
Thank you, Ryan.
All credit to you. Caldwell controls. Chiquetto. Chiquetto, the 5'11 guard, a junior, swings it on over. Calavera back on out. He gets the ball back as he swings it on away. As you said, Nate Nussbaum checking in the game, getting some key minutes now for the Lancers in this four-point spread. He's screened off his man as he gets back. Double team, unable to slice right through, but fouled is Calavera.
That's telling me.
And they're going to say he actually traveled out. That's a ball.
He did travel. And you mentioned, like I mentioned, Nate Nussbaum into the game. He's not letting Calavera getting any chances at threes. He knows, he saw in the first quarter that he can shoot, and he doesn't want that same fate to see the ball go in over his head. So for that reason, he's holding him tight at the three-point line.
Perlstein on outside. Luke Cohen back on outside to Perlstein. Cohen shoots a long three. Can't capitalize. Rebound. Defensive. Fought hard right there. Lance Jenkins. He stands 6'1", and he showed all of that right there. Ball loose. Lancer basketball.
I noticed Ian Madison down there. I mentioned his height and his athleticism. He's gotten a lot of defensive boards, but I want to see what he can do on the offensive end. He's been held scoreless, I believe, thus far, but I want to see him use his size and his athleticism.
Lancers control. Planting for a three. Nussbaum can't get it to go. Rebound and taken on up. Calavera. Bounce pass inside. Spin. And unable to finish right there is the big man. He gets the ball back. Can't finish once again. Relay, no good. Combined efforts right there from Jenkins and Madison don't work, and the Lancers catch a break. Still a four-point spread. Three ball. Perlstein wants to change that. Bricks the shot. Caldwell rebound. Raise him loose. He'll go against Perlstein. Tries to drive on through. Lays one up. Can't finish. Rebound. Tipped out of bounds, Lancer basketball.
I mentioned Madison trying to put the ball in the hoop from in tight. He appears to be cold. He's missed a couple shots now from in close. He needs to heat up. They haven't, neither team actually has scored yet to start this second quarter. Let's see that change here with the Lancer ball.
Smith, one-on-one. He gives it away. Now one-on-one is Nussbaum. Finds Perlstein. Finishing is Perlstein. One possession difference, Alex. The Lancers want to push the comeback after an angry start to this basketball game. And now that Lancers bench is on their feet. Caldwell. Need to get something going here. They're on a little cold streak. That three can't finish it. On the rebound with momentum is Cohen. Drives on through. And unable to tie this basketball game. Perlstein on the rebound. Unable to finish. And we have a whistle giving the basketball back to James Caldwell as the Lancers retreat back to their defensive end. And a key piece with an Avi Paulette stands next to his head coach in his 18th season and checks on in. He'll take out Nate Nussbaum. Nussbaum takes the seat. Good run for him.
We talked to Coach Fest before the game. I've said it a million times about pushing the pace. The games are moving a lot faster, but honestly, it's hurting Caldwell. Their once 12-point lead is now just one possession.
Three ball. Gets it to go. Lance Jenkins. As he checks in, he cracks the scoreboard. For Caldwell off that cold streak. Okay. Smith.
They're slowing the pace again.
Smith pickpocketed and says he didn't touch the basketball last, and he is correct according to the official. Lancer basketball.
And no shot clock in high school basketball, as we mentioned every time, makes a key difference in these games. Bounce pass into Avi Pallette. Ryan Lowey, Alex Weiss on color, Jordan Cooper on camera. Back on over. Sam Smith. Bounce pass Pallette. Pallette loses the basketball. He's pickpocketed on it. Sam Blute. Sam Blute drives through Cohen. Blocked by Cohen. I believe Cohen is called on the foul. And Caldwell looks like they will make their way towards the line for some free throws.
We saw Sam Blute with a little stutter step there as he approached the three-point arc. He's a dangerous shooter. He has 43s on the season in only 16 games. So his shot from beyond the arc is something to watch for. But Cohen stuck with him. Unfortunately, he did foul him, but he was able to stay on his man.
Sam Blute makes the first.
No surprise there. He leads his team coming into tonight with 41 free throws. That was his 42nd. However, he did miss the second attempt.
Bodner hit the hard court hard on the trip. He looks to be all right. Pass connection, Pearlstein deflected off the basketball, and Caldwell on the takeaway and the drive. Chiquetto is on the basketball.
I like that cut by Pearlstein, though. It's a good look for the Lancers.
Hand off, swung on around. Sozio gives it away. Recourses. You don't want to leave Chiquetto open, as there he is finishing a three ball. Again, Lancers really need to defend that three marker. That's one of their inserting keys to the second half. There's only 2:40 left to go in the second quarter.
That is the fifth three that the Chiefs have got to fall in this first half. Run.
Luke Cohen, Pearlstein. Finger roll, can't go. He gets his own rebound as he punches it on out. Quick pass on over to Sam Smith. Air in that basketball. James Caldwell on it. Chiquetto gives it away. Driving on in. Bodner couldn't take the charge. Called against him. What do you think of that call, Alex?
I don't agree, but luckily for the Lancers, the shot attempt after did not go in. Sam Blute 1-for-2 from the line thus far. The Lancers are hoping here that he does not continue his success from this season. First shot did not go in. It was a 1-and-1. Lancers down by 9 now.
Cohen. On out, Smith. Bodner, he gets a crack from the scoreboard today. Whistles blow. Subs told to wait.
Clock's going.
Clock is still running as the fans want to make it known.
Clock's running.
They're really making themselves viable as it finally stopped at the minute 59. I believe they will probably add 10 seconds. Close. We stopped it at 2:09. We'll see what they do. But Alex, while we have the time, Livingston really leaving Caldwell open for threes, and it's been costing them.
It has been. That's 15 points off the three ball thus far. That's 15 of their 20 points. Livingston's down 9. If they had contested these threes more, and which we're going to see them do here in the second half, that margin of that lead for Caldwell is going to start to dwindle if they can really contest this three ball.
Basket went in!
So we're not sure exactly what is going on here. The score is 20-11.
We hear these Caldwell parents. They think, I believe it was the free throw they're complaining about.
They want to officiate the game, Alex. And I'll tell you this. No wonder there's a shortage of basketball officials in the state of New Jersey. They're all in the stands.
I think some of these parents ought to put some black and white striped shirts on and throw them on the hardwood.
They want to be the impromptu zebras of this matchup, as it looks like we have a substitution. Bodner standing towards his bench. Is he coming off?
Is that the captain Warder that might be stepping onto the court? We will see here. The Lancers look like they do have 5, however, so I don't think the senior captain, Zach Warder, is going to be able to step on just yet, but he will eventually be played for these Lancers.
So we have a long questioning stoppage of play right here, Alex. And any thoughts recently on the Livingston catch-up in the second quarter?
Well, unfortunately for the Lancers, they have been playing from behind quite a lot this season. I do think, however, that... Sorry, we just got a shout-out from one of the fans. But, yeah,
they've been playing from behind a lot.
But if they can tighten up on their perimeter defense, I think it's going to be a very... It's going to be a very manageable second half lead for them to conquer.
As we see the officials deliberating, 2:09 on the clock now, and it seems as though they will
have reshoot his free throws. It's probably the right call to make here, Ryan, as where they're up 9, potential to make it 11 on the 1-1 here from Zamloot. Right away, shoots it.
Can't finish. Looks like they made him retake the second foul shot, and it was no good. 20-11. James Caldwell leads Alex, so it looks like that was situated. An interesting, solid 2 to 3 minutes of stoppage and play. Gave us the chance to preview the second half for you. Miscommunication finds the Lancers on the basketball as the whistle comes in.
That's backcourt violation.
Looks like James Caldwell's parents not too happy with the situation there.
I want to point out, before the stoppage, Avi Pallad bring the ball up court. Again, take his time. Caldwell wants to push the pace here, but when the games are moving at a faster pace, they've actually been suffering. Their lead dwindled down to only 2 points, but now that the Lancers are finding their slower groove, it's actually hurting their offense.
Three ball. Off the rim and out, but right back into the hands of Chiquetta. A 5'11 guard. Relays one on out. He gets it back. He sneaks on through. 10 finishes the layup. Caldwell up double digits. They've reached their largest lead of the day. It's 11.
Good. Some cheerleaders here. But we also need a Caldwell bench. We're applauding the guys on the court. Their defense has been really good this fall.
Pallad with a nice play. Opens up for Pearlstein. His three fits right through.
No doubt about that one going in, Ryan. Silences the Chiefs bench. It's an 8-point spread here with just over a minute to go in this first half. The timeout called by the Lancers.
The Lancers will burn another timeout with 20 seconds left to go in their timeout. It's a short 30-second timeout. That's a big three. That can really push momentum for Livingston.
Ryan, you know I love to talk about momentum, and the Lancers are going to need a lot of it coming out of this first half and into the third quarter. If we could see them continue to hit those threes, specifically Dylan Pearlstein knocking out these shots from the perimeter, it's going to be a good start to the second half for these Lancers. Ryan, 64 seconds on the clock. It's going to be Caldwell ball coming off that Pearlstein three. Do you think they're going to push the pace and go for a quick basket, or do you think that they're going to hold out and try and get the last shot?
Talavera will now throw it in for the James Caldwell. Minute of basketball left to play. Alex Weiss, Jordan Cooper, D1 Media for Page NFL. I would like to thank you for spending your Thursday evening with us. It's High School Hoops. Take it
blocked
away.
By Pallad.
Cohen, on out. Lancers will now take their time. No shot clock in high school basketball. Big effect on the last minute of every quarter of action in every game at the boys and girls level. Caldwell girls basketball also having a phenomenal season. They're taking on Mount St. Dominic's Academy this evening.
Looks like Lancers are going to hold out for the last shot here. 26 ticks as we have a foul call. It's going to be a 1-1 for the Lancers, I believe. Check that, it's going to be an inbound from the sideline.
Six. Ryan Lawrence, the game for the Chiefs.
Be Cohen inbounding the ball here with 25.8 ticks of the clock remaining in this first half. Lancers looking like they're going to hold out for this last shot. It is inbounded to Pallad. Now Cohen retakes possession.
Cohen from the outside. Pearlstein.
Lots of screens going on in the middle there.
Smith wants a three from long. It goes!
That's a three-pointer for Sam Smith.
Sam Smith. And it's a 5-point spread. 2 seconds, 1 second. I wave a whistle with just 1 second left.
That's going to be a shooting foul on Pallad. But what a shot there by Smith. We talked about momentum. That's momentum. Two threes here for the Lancers to close out the half. That's huge for them as their lead, as the Chiefs lead is only 5 now. Let's see if Chiquetta can extend it at the line. He does. First shot is good. Chiquetta coming into this game has 36 free throws for these Chiefs, second to only Zamloot on the roster as he sinks his second one.
Thrown on in. 1 second left, the last second move will not do the job as it is halftime here in Livingston. Lancers 18, James Caldwell 23. We have the halftime report coming up next right on the D1 Maple Bridge on the NFHS Network, presented by Andrew Orthopedics.
Right up the middle, battling towards the goal line. Baldwin is in for a Vance touchdown.
right down the middle, man. Just got, and he keep going, and he
oh, what, the ball loose?
And they hop back on it, and that's a touchdown.
Short punt, bounces at the 35, fielded at the 40 by Quick, out to the corner. He's got blockers and a lot of green grass in front of him. Cuts back, he's in for a touchdown!
Swing pass in the flat. Touchdown.
Good job, block. Third down and 17, a handoff. Getting to the outside. There's a hole. There's a first down. And all the way to the races is Elijah McWilliams to the house for a touchdown and for an IMIC for a division championship.
Throw line, tries to dump a pass off, gets intercepted. Freeman all the way to the hole. Oh, what a block by Moore! Left to play in the fourth quarter. Cromartie, three, got it! Davis probes in the corner, three-pointer, up and down! Brown again! His second straight three! Roselle Catholic in a hurry. Wilcher back to Bueno, he's gonna try and tie it, and he does! Oh, big shots all around! He can't get around, and a turnover. Corey Floyd has it. Step through, Lyon throws the basket. Here's Kramer. Kramer walking in. Pass in front, they score! Puck comes back out to the point. Gorski with a shot, and then they score! Slap shot from the point, blocked aside. Here comes Kent Bishop, walking in shorthanded. They scores!
Walk ahead for the Marauders.
Here comes Bengals, they score!
Michael Bengals for St. Petersburg, and they lead it 3-2.
The celebration is underway! The horn sound! And the Glen Rock Panthers are the McGinnis Cup champions! But that's gonna do it! The revenge tour is complete! The Don Bosco Prep Ironmen are the Gordon Cup Conference champions!
Hands up, Jack. On the scene.
Oh! Roll Hostess took him and defeated
him. E.D. Horton. Horton dribbles into the front court to Khalil Whitney. Going to the basket and the jam!
Conversation with them because they are getting resources from the city. They are getting resources, and they're arguing with us about the timeliness of those resources.
D. Do you want your school to be covered by the number one live stream service in the state of New Jersey so the entire country can see moments like this?
We play once again. Free kick coming for the Mountaineers. Short shot on goal on post. And West Orange gets the goal. And they win. They take down the number two ranked Seton Hall Pirates.
Bullock takes the snap. He's going to take it himself. Barreling towards the goal line and he's in. Taj Bullock from 3 yards out. And the Marauders lead it 20-7.
Or be a witness to championships like these.
Montclair are state sectional champions. They defeat Livingston 4-1, and the Mounties sweep the boys and girls brackets in back-to-back wins over the Lancers.
3-2, there goes the runners. Swing on and miss, strike three, that does it.
Welcome back here to the second half of action right here on the D1 Media Pro page on the NFHS Network. My name is Ryan Lowey. I am joined with Alex Weiss. And after a little dispute between the officials, we have an announcement. The score is 24-17. We're not sure what the technical difficulties were here in the facility, but we do know that the official score is 24-17.
Yeah, it was pretty funny. The last few minutes or so of this first half, yeah, the issue, the free throw, the dispute as to whether or not it actually entered the hoop, the whole clock dispute and the stoppage of the game. And finally, at half, the discussions were made, the correct people were talked to, and now we have a 7-point spread. Lancers trailing 17-24, just 3 minutes away from tip-off here, and the Lancers are out here warming up, and they look ready to go, Ryan. Like we mentioned, momentum. Two threes there to end the half, and it doesn't look like it's slowing down. Smith and Pearlstein both contributing here. Let's see what the Lancers have in store for the second half of basketball.
Lancers, Caldwell, second half, right after this. Third quarter of action right here at Livingston High School's Fieldhouse facility in Livingston, Essex County, New Jersey. And Alex, what are we looking forward to in the second half?
We're looking forward to some action-packed basketball here. The Lancers with momentum hitting two key threes thanks to the skill of Sam Smith and Dylan Pearlstein, seen respectively. That just spot. We've also seen the performance of on the defensive end. The call up. Start this game. Start the second. Very expensive. Meanwhile, on the other side, in blue, in this halftime, let's see if they can come out flying in the second half. My guys, Chicago, and Dean Madison, a big body who has been fundamental on the glass for this Chiefs defense. 23, 22, 21, the clock is ticking here in halftime. Refs getting ready to start off this second half. Very exciting game here, presented by D1 Media Pro on the NFHS Network. Lancers looking to cut this lead that the Chiefs have done so well to maintain, having lost it since tip-off. Meanwhile, the Chiefs are trying to extend the lead, which has dwindled down to 2 at points, but has been as large as 11. Ryan, what is important here to the Lancers? What do you think they're going to need to do coming out of this half here to cut down the lead that the Chiefs have built up in the first half.
Well, we're taking a look at a starting five that was exactly the same as the beginning of the game. So I think that the Lancers really just need to come out cracking. Obviously, a little score dispute shouldn't detest anybody from just putting their best on out there this half, because it is anyone's game. A tough start to the game for Livingston, but they've really bounced back, and they're really putting their all on out there, Alex. We're underway with the third quarter of action. Caldwell controls. Mid-range jumper. Can't go. Brick on the shot. Livingston controls.
Livingston bench is really into this, Ryan.
Three ball. Rimming out. Rebound. Controlled by James Caldwell. Swung on over close side. Pass on out far. Caldwell drive on end, pass inside, connection, and finish. James Caldwell, two more on the board. They hold a 9-point lead. Ryan Lawrence cracks the scoreboard for James Caldwell the second half. Cohen, right inside, big wrist, stripped to the basketball, he falls on it. He fights for it. Whistle blows, and the Lancers call it's another timeout. So the Lancers call a timeout, we'll be right back.
Right up the middle, barreling towards the goal line, Baldwin is in for a Vance touchdown.
Right down the middle, man. This guy, man, he keep going and
the ball's ball loose.
And they hop back on it. That's a touchdown.
Short punt, bounds at the 35, fielded at the 40 by Quick. Out to the corner. He's got blockers and a lot of green grass in front of him. Cuts back. He's in for a touchdown.
Swing pass in the flat. Touchdown.
Good job, block. Third down and 17. A handoff. Getting to the outside. There's a hole. There's a first down. And all the way to the races is Elijah McWilliams to the house. A touchdown, and for an IMIC for a division championship.
We're back for the third quarter. We're about a minute in, Alex. Both teams have cracked the scoreboard this third quarter. This is Lancer basketball out of bounds.
I want to see them get the ball to DePola down low. He's been posting up pretty well.
Pearlstein lays one up and finishes. Dylan Pearlstein.
He's been great.
Three ball. A contesting three is no good. Rebound offensive. Swung on back out. Driving on in, laying it on up, and unable to finish. Poked off the backboard. Caldwell still controls. Pivot. Swung on outside.
It's another rebound by Madison.
Time for Caldwell. Back on in, this pass connects from the inside, fouled, and traveling, as a matter of fact, actually, for Caldwell is Ian Madison. Thrown on in.
Just, I just elapsed here. He's been all over the score sheet tonight for the Lancers, and he needs to continue to be that way. The Lancers want to cut the 7-point lead.
Big wrist, can't finish, can't get himself on the board today. He'll hustle back on defense. Here comes Caldwell. Time now for Chiquetto. Swung on around. Pass inside, deflected out of bounds.
That was off Carter.
Sam Bodner into the game for the Lancers.
Bodner will now check in.
Big wrist taking a seat.
Basketball thrown on in. From the mid-range, back out for a three. Plenty of time for Chiquetto, as he's able to get the lucky roll.
This is good for Rocco Chiquetto.
Caldwell now up by double digits worth of 10, 29-19. Remember, Alex, a score dispute was finally settled, and they finally figured it out. Here's a three from Cohen. Can't go. Rebound, Massimo DePaola out of bounds.
You see Moss, the sophomore, the call-up, despite this, he's still giving his all. He's fighting for the ball, and as a result, the Lancers are going to have a chance here as they will inbound from the baseline.
Cohen. Handoff. Cohen will now take his time with 5 minutes. Cohen pivots and finishes.
Going around his body weight there, finishing with the left hand.
29-21.
A 9-point lead for the Chiefs. They took the 15-minute trip on down here. Pivot, bounce pass. From the mid-range, swung on out.
You notice Madison down there, watched very closely by DePola. He's now on the outside, give and go.
Chucked on up. Unlucky roll, DePola gets the rebound.
He's looked great to start the second half, Ryan.
Here's Smith. Outside three, blocked. But it will remain Lancer basketball as it goes out of bounds.
That was the big Madison with the rejection. Madison sitting at 6'5". Senior forward there with the rejection.
Sam Smith. Relayed on over. Bodner. Luke Cohen. Pearlstein. Around and about goes Pearlstein. Luke Cohen. Back on out. A nice move, and the mid-ranger is blocked. Wow, Madison. Madison really flexing his muscles. Having quite the game. Three ball. Unlucky roll. Massimo fights for the rebound. That's what they called him up for, Alex. Swung on out. Three ball from Cohen. This is big. And this fits.
That's huge. 5-point spread now.
Talavera. The Lancers bench getting on their feet. This would be a huge win for them, Alex. It's already been a great three-quarter performance bouncing off of a tough start.
Chiquetta's calling for the ball there in the corner, and they'll give it to him.
Caldwell control, swung on out. Time for Talavera. Lancers bench trying to get loud. Pivot, Madison throws one up. Wildly off. Ball finds Cohen. It's getting loud. Lancers didn't bring too big of a student section here this evening, but they're trying to bring in the voices. Lancers cheerleaders also doing an excellent job trying to bring in the action. And we have a whistle. Looks like there's a foul. And it's going to be a blocking foul called against Talavera. Substitution, key substitution. Poled checks in.
Yeah, you mentioned, actually, I mentioned the first half that Madison was from intent. You see that again, you couldn't get the left to fall. That's played correct in the backcourt for the Lancers.
Poled, bounce pass to Bodner. Back on outside. Relayed on up, and rejected away. Here comes Caldwell. Relayed on up, no good. A good Bodner rebound. Here come the Lancers. Poled, rejected by Madison. Madison having quite the ball game. Here comes Caldwell. What a finish. We have whistles coming in as a much needed timeout comes in. But Chiquetto is able to finish. 31-24, Caldwell really clicking. Livingston now burns another timeout.
Well, the Lancers started off this quarter down 7. They've chopped it down to 6. Here with
don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, 7, 1 o'clock is senior night. Both I think the boys and the cheerleaders, come on down. 7, 1 o'clock.
They're going to need to get it down to realistically 4 or 5, entering the 4th, now the chance of this. You mentioned how big of a win this would be for the Lancers. Last place and first place here. It'll be down to city for the Chiefs. But a really huge crowd this for these Lancers who struggled as of late.
So that timeout was actually charged to Caldwell, as they will have 4 remaining and the Lancers only 1. A 7-point spread. As Sean Kolesarich, the team photographer for the Livingston Lancers, enters the building. 10 seconds left to go here in the timeout, Alex. And Livingston really just needs to keep clicking from behind the 3-line if they want to punch their ticket into a close fourth quarter.
They do. Pearlstein with 3 on the day, contributing. Kind of 13 points from behind the arc. He's going to need to step it up. He's going to start either knock out. He's going to need to start knocking down threes. He and Smith as well. Smith has recorded a three-pointer in this game. We're going to need to get hot here in the last 2.5 minutes of this third quarter going into the fourth. Ryan?
Pearlstein will take it up for the Lancers with 2 minutes left to go in the third. Passed on in Bodner.
They're doubling the ball here.
Cohen. Laid on up, Pearlstein. Excuse me, that was Avi Poled as it swung on out. Three ball. Bricked, but rebounded by DePaula. Swung on out, Pearlstein. Can't finish, but the Lancers still control. Avi Poled recourses. His pass is tipped out of bounds. So Cohen will get ready to throw it in, but these Lancers really applauding the effort from DePaula. DePaula really showing off his muscles and strength. The sophomore is really a fighter. He also plays baseball. He gets some varsity minutes this year under Coach Ennis, who we played for last year at the freshman level.
I agree. Moss is an athlete, letting his presence be known at the varsity level tonight. As we see, the Lancers trying to go to work on offense here.
Luke Cohen. Lancers are trapped as this basketball finds its way out of bounds. We're going to say it's going to stay here.
It was a great play by Pearlstein to stay in bounds after receiving that pass. Nice little toe tap action that you see from guys on the gridiron. So Lancers will retain possession of the offensive baseline.
Cohen. Avi Poled, Luke Cohen. 80 seconds left to play here in the third quarter. Poled, Bodner. Bounce pass deflected off of a Chief. And a whistle. And it's going to be a kick ball violation, and it will stay with Livingston. Kicking motion shown right there by the Caldwell defender with a minute 18. Luke Cohen posts up for a three. He can't finish. Time on the rebound for Sozio. He guns one down the court. And the finish. Lawrence.
That's the pace that Coach Fess was talking about. They got the ball quick, they got it up the court quick, and put it in the basket. Lynch's ball now with under a minute to go.
Sam Smith stays in bounds. Smith for three. He stepped out of bounds, though.
It's a fortunate two. That shot was good. Had he stayed in bounds, that would have made it a six-point margin with 50 o'clock remaining here in quarter number three. Looks like we got some substitutions here. Talavera. Step into the game.
Chris Talavera back in the game for.
So some key substitutions as Talavera will return for Caldwell. Talavera having quite the year. This whole Caldwell team really just impressing everyone. A miracle run. 3-4 years back, they were a solid team, but nobody thought they would have this good of a record. Only 2 losses to 15 wins. This is game number 18. They're trying to take down the Lancers and further clinch that first spot going into the state tournament. Remember, there is promotion and relegation to the agreement of the athletic directors here in the Super Essex Conference. Caldwell looking to hopefully post their way into the second division.
The success of this Chiefs team, that 15-2 record is outstanding. That's in .882 win percentage. That's including an 11-1 record within their conference. Looking to make it 12 tonight.
Pearlstein, high to K, he can't handle. And K fouls. Interesting decision there by Matt K. Wants to slow down the momentum, as we saw James Caldwell on the momentum earlier in the first quarter, absolutely powering through the Lancers, turnover after turnover.
There was a lot of miscommunication to start off this game for the Lancers. Now we're starting to see some of that relapse here as the Lancers turn over the ball on a very high pass that was not able to be corralled. Another substitution here.
Chris Talavera back in the game for the Chiefs.
Talavera re-subbing into the game after he just stepped in a minute ago. You hear the Lancers cheerleaders getting loud. The Lancers look to make a stop on defense. 15 seconds left here, Ryan.
Bounce pass. Caldwell control. Sam Lute on over. Chiquetto. This will be the final possession of the third quarter before we have the fourth. Last second heave. More like a bullet than an actual layup shot. So that will do the third quarter. We have the fourth quarter coming up. Lancers down by 9, 33-24. The visiting first place James Caldwell Chiefs over the last place Lancers. Stay tuned. action right here from the field house. James Caldwell up 33-24 over the Livingston Lancers. It's Lancer basketball.
The sophomore DePola is back on the court for the Lancers.
So Matt Kay to inbound it for the Lancers. Kay on out. Sam Smith, Matt Kay. 7:45 left to play here in this one. Three ball. Can't go. Rebound punched out of bounds by Livingston. James Caldwell will take over.
Dylan Carlstein and Andrew Pallette back in the game for the Lancers.
It's Kay and Bonner stepping out for Pallette.
Keep ball out of
bounds. And we'll check back into the game with 20 seconds left in this fourth quarter.
Half a minute in. Chiquetto gives it away. Zamlut to the big man. Madison having quite the game. There he is pivoting through, but unable to finish. Madison having trouble putting the ball into the net. Not sure if it's just that Livingston atmosphere, but he's unable to finish today. Cohen, right around. Avi Pallette. Luke Cohen.
Coach Cohen making calls from the sideline.
Three ball. It's good. A great finish by Luke Cohen. Livingston within six. They're really putting up a fight against this tough James Caldwell squad.
Lancers bench is really into it, Ryan.
Mid-ranger. Fade away. Goes through. Talavera. 8 point spread now. Avi Pallette on out. Good connection inside, but Madison has other thoughts.
Madison, despite his struggles on the offensive end, has a great under the Chiefs basket. He's swatting balls left and right, getting boards consistently throughout this game. He's been a key factor for this Caldwell lead.
Thrown on in and taken away. The big man is fouled and will go to the line, counted and one. A big effort right there. Caldwell up double digits to try and add on. Madison, the 6'5 senior photo. Well, Caldwell's going to miss him next year.
Yeah, his size is definitely the first thing you notice about him. But you look at his ability on defense, impeccable, as he finally gets the ball to go through the hoop at a crucial point, looking to extend this now double-digit lead for the Chiefs.
Shot no good. Rebound, Caldwell. Put back. No good either. Caldwell back on it again, and we have whistles on the floor. It'll stay right here, James Caldwell basketball.
I got excited there on the fast break for Madison. I thought we were going to see him throw one down. He was contested closely and then fouled by Pallette.
Caldwell basketballs, it's back in play. Swung on around, lightly contested three ball. Alex, as I said, you just don't want to leave Talavera open. Wow, that shot, beautiful.
That's his third three of the game. As the Chiefs now eclipse the 40-point mark.
Caldwell a 13-point lead. Livingston showing signs of running out of gas this fourth quarter. Cohen, he's fouled.
Lancer ball out.
So it's Lancer basketball. Cohen will now throw it in. Back on in. Smith. Basketball. Out of bounds.
That was an unnecessary touch by the Chiefs. That was Chiquetto trying to save the ball, was not able to do so. And the Lancers will go to work, down 13.
Pearlstein on out, mid-range jumper. Avi Pallette can't get the roll. Basketball out of bounds, and they're now gonna say Caldwell takes over. And while Alex, James Caldwell, really running away with this one.
They are, and listen, it's never, it's, there's no such thing as a game that ends before the final horn. The Lancers are gonna struggle. They're down 13, and realistically speaking, it's gonna be a very tough one. And these first place Caldwell Chiefs have been tough to beat. As another shot by Talavera falls. Now the lead is 15. The Lancers are so resilient, though. They're gonna keep fighting for the final horn.
Avi Pallette. Back on out, 5 minutes left to play. Cohen. He drives through, he finds a lane. He's rejected, but there is a foul. Livingston bench trying to get back into it. Down 15, Alex.
Yeah, just over 5 minutes.
Luke on the line.
Colo has been very good from the line this year, leading the Lancers with 22 free throws made coming into tonight.
First shot, no good.
Jim went dead silent for Cohen to shoot his first shot. We're expecting the same atmosphere for the second. Your pin dropping here.
Very quiet crowd. Livingston really trying to push themselves back in. Second shot goes.
13-point game once again. Chiquetto for three.
No good. Rebound, Livingston. Paled. Here he comes now.
Talavera is watching him closely. Full court press for him. Nice move, though.
Paled drives on through. Back out. Luke Cohen. Three ball from Pearlstein. Gets it to go. 11-point spread. That ball is gunned on down the court. A nice catch by Madison. Pivots and finishes, but he traveled. Livingston trying to heave some momentum. And now we have whistles and a substitution. Sam Bodner checks in as he will take out Massimo DePaula. And DePaula is somebody, no matter the result of this basketball game, got to be happy with how he played.
Extremely. He's looked really good tonight. Upperclassmen giving him lots of props for his effort. Pearlstein once again with the ball to Paled.
Avi Paled going up against Madison. Madison, the Caldwell defensive and rebounding on offense threat. Paled does not decide to shoot on Madison. He connects with Pearlstein, and Pearlstein is able to make this a one-possession difference with half of the fourth quarter left to go. Ryan Lowry, Alex Weiss, Jordan Cooper, D1 Media, Propage, NFHS Network, Livingston, James Caldwell Basketball, Super Essex Conference Hoops, third division of play. Caldwell drives on through. A brilliant SportsCenter top 10 play by Talavera.
Chris Talavera for two.
What a finish. Nice spin on that ball. Driving to the lane, no fear. He's looking to get the third point in what was a phenomenal finish. Talavera showing his unique talent, finishing ability at the rim there.
Quite the game this Caldwell offense has been having. The threes have just really spilled for him as there's a lucky roll. One thing we've noticed, excluding Madison, Caldwell really getting the lucky rolls as well from behind the marker. We've seen a lot dribble right on through.
On the other side of the court, we've seen Pearlstein, 18 points thus far with just under 4 minutes remaining in this fourth quarter. That's including four three-pointers. He's been hot despite the fact that the Lancers are down 12. If he stays hot, this game's going to finish a lot closer than you might think, right?
Back on in. Paled gets it back. Oh, a nice move by Paled. Opens up the court. Gives Pearlstein, who's hot, a shot for three. Can't get the lucky roll. It's in and out. 3 minutes. 3.5 to play. Here comes Caldwell. Bounce pass. Sozio. Mid-range jumper. That's off from Jenkins. Offensive rebound. Pass inside. Sozio can't finish. On the putback, it's no good. But we have a whistle and a charger. A charge gives the ball back to Livingston.
The Lancer bench is ecstatic. The Chiefs parents are not, as we see Paled crossing off court vigorously.
Paled opens up the court. Can't get the finger roll. Offensive rebound. Three ball. Smith sinks it.
Second three-pointer of the game for Smith, and that's a huge one. This gym is turning electric, Ryan.
What a finish.
That's high arc on that one.
Livingston with the spread of 9. Passed on in. Miscommunication. Madison. What a fight. What an effort by Smith. And we have a whistle. Basketball rebound. Wow. And Livingston will take over.
The timeout by the Chiefs. They're starting to worry. It's a 9-point spread with 2:42 left to go. What a fight by the Lancers on defense. What a shot. That was Smith with the high arcing three. We got ourselves the game here, Ryan.
We'll be right back. 36-45. Livingston trying to come back.
Over to Floyd, he's open, thought about the three, drives baseline. Oh, what a start for Corey Florence!
Free throw line, tries to dump a pass off, gets intercepted. Freeman all the way to the hole. Oh, what a block by Moore! Left to play in the fourth quarter. Cromartie, three, got it! Davis probed in the corner, three-pointer, up and down! Brown again! His second straight three! Rozelle Catholic in a hurry. Wilcher back to Bueno. He's going to try and tie it. And he does! Oh, big shots all around! He can't get around and a turnover. Corey Floyd has it. Step through, lay it down the basket! Fourth quarter action. The Lancers are down by nine. A great fight for the basketball. Now here they come on it. Pared drives on through. Outside. Nice connection to Cohen. Gets the lay-in.
Really nice cut by the son of the coach.
8 in his 18th year at the helm. His son, Luke Cohen, second team All-Division last year.
Foul's number one, Luke Cohen, that's his fourth.
Speaking of Cohen, fourth foul of the game here. Caldwell inbound.
Immediate inbound from Caldwell. Three ball, Talavera can't get the roll. Basketball kept in bounds, a great effort. Talavera gets the roll. That's big for Caldwell. 100 seconds left to play. Bodner. Can't get the lucky roll. Punched back in, but unable to go. Caldwell on the basketball. Talavera will take his time with 90 seconds left. Excuse me, minute 50 left to play. And we have whistles.
That was a really unfortunate roll there. For just couldn't get it to fall.
So a foul on the court, and the official will point to Sozio to play this ball back in. Caldwell trying to secure a very tough victory against who they might consider to be an easy win in their division. Alex just continues to fight.
They continue to fight, Ryan. Like you said, you see the shot fall. Lancers are showing a lot of resilience, despite not being great statistically. When you watch the games, you see no quit from this Lancers team, even in a game that looks to be slipping out of their hands.
Cohen drives on through, he's fouled. He'll go to the line. A good fight there by Cohen, Alex.
Yeah, Cohen especially, you mentioned his success individually, despite the fact that the Lancers haven't looked great this season. He's heading to the line. They are down 11, looking to make it a 9-point spread, bring this lead to single digits.
First shot is in.
Nothing but net for Cohen. As this lead dwindles to 10, looking to make it 9.
Big shot now for Cohen. As the second one rolls right through. Smooth like butter, Alex.
Best jar of peanut butter seed, Ryan.
Hit pocketed. They're gonna say it was off his foot. Lancer basketball. Oh, Chiquetto on the wrong side of that one.
9-point spread. About 80 seconds left to play. It's definitely not probable, but it's not impossible, Ryan.
Pled. Bounce pass deflected off a Chief. Lancers keep it in. Outside, Smith sees a lane. Bounce pass outside. Three ball, Cohen. Impossible angle, can't go. Rebound, James Caldwell. Chiquetto on the rebound. He passes it on out. Planting for three ball. Now recoursing. It is Zamlute on over. A good 1-2 connection. See Sozio finishing it. 11-point spread. And we have a whistle for a foul. Caldwell now just want to run out that clock.
Yeah, you mentioned before, no shot clock. That's going to be big for them. They can get an offensive possession. But Pled was fouled, and now we're going to see Cohen inbound it. That's Pearlstein.
Luke Cohen
Cohen drives through. Cohen with two steps and the lay-in. The nice backspin there. You can really tell the collegiate level of backspin.
Great job protecting the ball on the way in. Nice finish there.
So now Caldwell will try and burn as much time as possible. No foul called with 20 seconds. The spread is 9 points, and Livingston look to be giving up on it.
I think we're just going to see a game of keep away here. As we reach the 10-second mark, 9-point spread, our final, 51-42.
And it looks like the only thing that's left, Alex, the traffic. So a good fight for the Lancers, but Caldwell, a 9-point victory within 51-42. So that will do it. Caldwell continues to show their supreme reign of the third division of Essex County Hoops. And the Lancers, another tough loss as they fall with only 4 wins on the year for them. This will be their 14th loss of the season. Chiefs, they keep rolling 16-2 and look to hopefully start up another winning streak. Ryan Lowey, Alex Weiss, Jordan Cooper, we'll catch you next time as we're signing off from Livingston High School's very good field house in Livingston, Essex County, New Jersey. Toodaloo.
He's going to take it himself for a championship. A double play wins it.
Turn it to the end zone. What a catch. McCutcheon touchdown.